Path deformer and warp deformer, which one is the best? Hello everyone, I'm Auni and this is How to Live2D. If you have been using Live2D for a bit of time, you might have checked YouTube videos about it to learn, and by doing so, you might have noticed there are a lot of ways to do the same thing. Today I'm covering the topic of hair, or actually any swishy fabric or layer, like in my OC. There are mainly two ways to make parameters for hair, which are warp deformer and path deformer. There is actually a third one called skinning, which is very used by Live2D users who make VTuber models, but it is a very advanced feature and in the paid version of Live2D, so I won't cover it here since this is a beginner-friendly tutorial. I might make a tutorial about it in future, but let's see with the time, I guess. To show you both of the deformer functionalities, I created two different models. The first one is a Missandei chibi model, and the second one is a Jaqen H'ghar fan art. Very different, aren't they? Both of the characters are from A Song of Ice and Fire, also known as Game of Thrones, so every right goes to the creator George Martin, not to me. I'm just a fan who likes drawing characters from the series they love. Let's start with the path deformers. For the newbies here, how does a path deformer works? First thing, path deformer is this icon. To apply it to one model, select one layer, then click on Path Deformer. Now, by clicking on your model's part, you will be able to create little green dots. And if you drag one of them, it moves your layer. Why would someone want to pick this deformer over the warp one? Well, first thing, it is very, very easy to use. You just need to click a button and drag the green dots around. It takes almost zero effort, and it's very simple, unlike, well, a lot of things in Live2D. Path deformer gives its best results on long and thin model parts, like the jacket's flowy hair or his long cape. It also allows undulating and wide, slow movements. Most models use path deformer for high blinking and mouth lip sync, just like in my model right now. I'm using path deformers to blink my eyes and move my mouth, but mouth doesn't really work. Sad story. On the cons side, path deformer can't be father-child read. I don't know how to explain it easily. To put it simple, father child in Live2D is putting one deformer inside the other, so the first deforms the layer while being deformed by the second. It's very easy to do and hard to explain, but okay. And other than this, path deformer isn't very versatile and it might not give good results when physics are applied to the motion, like in VTuber models. It's better for illustrations. I chose to use this in my illustration because it doesn't need physics and won't be used as a real-time model like my model right now. So most of path deformer cons don't really apply to it. So yeah. Moving to Missandei, I will show you the warp deformers. I have made a tutorial about warp deformers earlier, and I will probably remake it since it's a bit old. But if this is your first time in my channel and using a warp deformer, this is all you need to know. Warp deformer is this icon here. You can create one and it will contain your layer. By pinching and dragging it, it will deform your mesh, and you can move it around as you want. Warp deformer can be used with the parent-child relationship, meaning you can put one inside the other and both will work fine. Warp deformer are good at giving pretty light movements and to make bouncy motions. This deformer is the best option if you have to rig a model which won't be animated directly. So, for example, VTuber models which move according to your real-time actions, or website models which move following the mouse cursor. It is also the best way to rig hair which is not straight and long, for example with Missandei's coils. I really like rigging curly hair because it's very easy, it takes few time, and it's very cute, so yeah. While for path deformers, all you need to do is dragging the green dots left and right. Making a good movement with warp deformer can be a bit more tricky. To make it easy and fast, I usually make the horizontal movements and the vertical movements in two different warp deformers and parameters, and then link them and done. It will move automatically as you want, more or less. You can maybe need to fix some detail, but usually it's fast, it's easy, and it works fine, so why not? Since the warp deformer is often used to make bouncy motions, like in Missandei's curves, but not only Missandei's curves, you will find that many Live2D creators use warp deformers to animate boobs movements and body bouncing. I mean, it works fine, so let them do, I guess. An extra tip if you are a path deformer user. Remember when I mentioned the advanced rigging method called skinning? There is a little smart way to mimic it a little bit. I learned it thanks to my inspiration in Raichu, so all credit should go to her. Create a parameter right over your path deformer one, and place a rotation deformer at the root of your hair or whatever you are rigging. You should make it go left and right, then link your two parameters and you'll obtain a very smooth skinning-like movement in your free version of Live2D. But remember, if you have Live2D free version, you have a parameter limit, so use this wisely to avoid running out of parameters. I hope this video helped you a little bit with warp deformers and how to choose them, their pros and their cons, etc. Which one do you prefer? Do you prefer path deformers, or do you prefer warp deformers, or do you don't use this method and use another one? Do you know any tip you want to share in the comment, like the skinning-like version of path deformers? Just tell me in the comment, and thank you so much for watching this video. Bye-bye.